Now, this entire program has a theme about the gift of giving, starting with this very first story. You know, when we go to get vaccinated or tested for COVID-19, we sometimes don't really notice the people on the front lines, the people there to help us. Well, recently we went to Chuck Minker Sports Complex where there was a vaccination clinic, and we found out for everybody in line who has a story about how COVID has affected their lives, so do the people there to help us. Here at Chuck Minkert Sports Complex, the city of Las Vegas recently partnered with the Southern Nevada Health District to vaccinate people over 70 and those who work for any of our local utilities companies. This is an area of Las Vegas that is home to many who might have had a difficult time getting out to other locations to get their vaccine, or due to a financial or language barrier, simply didn't know where to go. Enrique Lopez knows this firsthand.
So I grew up a few blocks away on 28th Street in Bonanza. Then I went to Walter Bracken Middle School, grew up in this area. I actually grew up in the government houses that are no longer there. There's a public library there on 28th Street in Bonanza. That's where I grew up, here in this neighborhood. My dad would actually bring me to Chuck Minker as a kid. We'd play racquetball, basketball, go in the, learn taekwondo in the side room over there. So this was my old stomping grounds.
When word went out about this event to those who work at Las Vegas Fire and Rescue, Enrique was among the first to request being part of this 3-day vaccination effort.
As soon as I heard the name Chuck Minker and community service, I jumped at the chance. I emailed the chief right away. This is home. This is where I was a kid. My parents immigrated here from Mexico to give me a better life. They did. They accomplished that. I didn't know back then that we lived in, lower income housing and things of that nature. So now when this opportunity came up, I said, go back to my old neighborhood, give back.
Ideco Flores is with American Medical Response. She too wanted to be here because this was once her neighborhood.
You know, it's an honor. It always feels great to be able to come back to my community and give back to them. It just feels like the old days. I'm able to pretty much understand where everybody's coming from and able to translate for them, and it feels great.
Being fluent in both English and Spanish is a big advantage in this neighborhood where, for many, English is a second language. Enrique says his father's strict rule to speak Spanish at home and only English outside the home has enabled him to be of added help on the job and in situations like this.
Because he wanted us to have both languages. And so being able to serve the community here with my English and Spanish is a huge benefit, because I'm able to give back to not only my community, but even my bloodline, where my parents came from. Like I said, they immigrated here. So it feels good to do that and be able to give back in that sense as well.
Ideco agrees. She believes being able to communicate with everyone here provides added comfort in these unsettling times.
A lot of people come in nervous, not understanding the process. So just being able to ease their anxiousness, it helps out a lot.
Every single person serving at the testing and vaccination sites in our community is present out of dedication and a desire to help our community. But being from the same neighborhood as many of these people here at Chuck Minker enabled these two first responders to remember where they came from. And it prompted them to jump at the chance to give back. We all know that those people on the front lines at the testing and vaccination centers for long hours are not there because it's a party. They're there because they care about the community, and we all owe them a huge thank you during these scary and unprecedented times.